language and gestures as she takes us on a journey up Mount Kilimanjaro, Africa's highest freestanding mountain, with a speech entitled Summiting Kili. Please welcome Ali Dolphin. You're going to nail this, Ali, Matt said. I'd actually been looking for reassurance the day before because I was starting to feel really apprehensive about it. Madam President, fellow Toastmasters, fellow mountaineer and tent buddy, I have to say, climbing Mount Kilimanjaro has been one of the most hardest things I've ever done in my life. We'd already trekked for 5 days. We'd covered about 45 miles. It was really, really cold. Our muscles ached like mad. We were really tired because we'd not been able to sleep. We were already exhausted and we hadn't even started the summit up that mountain. It was 11 o'clock at night and we could see it way up there. As we looked up into the sky, the night was clear. The stars were twinkling, and it was beautifully calm and tranquil. There was an air of anticipation, because the whole group were nervous. Are we going to be able to make it to the top? There was some trepidation and excitement. We were organized in a line behind the leader. And Jill and I were at the front, following the pace setter. Everyone was wearing little head torches, so we could see. 11 o'clock at night, it was dark, just the twinkly lights. So as we look along the line that snakes up the mountain, all you see is a series of head torches, which looks quite magical, actually. Poly, poly! Call the guides, which means slowly, slowly. The emphasis is very much on going really slowly. 1 foot in front of the other foot, in front of the other foot. And then we come to great big boulders, which we have to heave ourselves up, sometimes holding on to tufts of grass or whatever we can get hold of, which is hard work in itself. Other times, we're walking along scree, so it's like sand. And as you're looking down at your feet, I was really conscious of the fact that the scree just fell off down the side of the mountain. And if I misplaced my foot, I could literally have slid down the mountain. Probably not very far, but nonetheless, it was actually really quite scary. I was really conscious of my breathing because at altitude there's less oxygen in the air and so you can't breathe so well. And the day before I'd been gasping for breath because of the height that we were at. So I was very conscious about breathing regularly. Also by that point, my brain had gone quite numb. You're so exhausted and just focusing on moving one foot after the other, your brain just stops working. Which is quite bizarre, to just not be able to think of anything other than mustering up enough energy to keep on going. So my strategy was to develop a mantra. All I could think about for 3 hours was, your toes are warm, your feet are comfortable, you can do this, you're breathing okay, you're not being sick, you've not got a headache, you're okay, keep going. And I repeated that literally for 3 hours because that's all I could manage to think about. It took 6 hours to reach Gilman's Point. Now, if you imagine from the base of the mountain to the top of the mountain, that's the 6 hour journey. Following which, you go round the crater, and as you go around the crater, you can look down into the volcano, which is just awesome. And we timed it so that when we reached Gilman's Point, we were there in time for the sunrise, which was magical. Having said that, we were just too exhausted to be able to appreciate it. This beautiful sunrise alongside a 30 metre vivid white glacier was just incredible. It took another 2 hours to reach the big sign, which you may well have seen, that says, "Congratulations, you have reached the highest point in Africa." My goodness, that was exhausting to get that far. However, reaching that sign was just triumphant. The sense of achievement, the sense of exhilaration, coupled with the absolute, total and utter exhaustion. People were taking photos. People were jostling in order to get there, in order to be able to have that prestigious photo. The achievement and the exhaustion were difficult to describe in words. It was just an incredible emotional moment. Because as I stood next to that sign, for those few moments that I was there having my photo taken, I was the highest person in the entire African continent, which was just quite phenomenal. And you know what? We nailed it.